I'm here to present a chronic presentation of VKH syndrome, a clinical case report in young female patient. Introduction. VKH syndrome is a multisystemic granulomatous, an autoimmune disease affecting organ with high melanocyte concentration, containing organs, for example, eye, central nervous system, inner ear, and skin. VKH syndrome is usually sporadic, but some familial cases have also been reported, indicating its hereditary basis. VKH is not associated with mortality, but it may result in long-term complications such as decreased vision associated with cataract and glaucoma. The American Uveitic Society diagnostic criteria for VKH syndrome included no history of ocular trauma, including surgery, and at least one finding of three out of the following four categories. First, bilateral chronic iridocyclitis, posterior uveitis, including exudative retinal detachment, disc hyperemia, or edema and sunset glow fundus. Third, neurogenic signs, tinnitus, meningismus, and cutaneous finding, for example, alopecia, poliosis, and vitiligo. Case discussion. We report a case of 33-year-old female patient complaining of occasional on and off swelling of eye with difficulty in seeing object at distant and near vision with glasses since last 5 years. No other specific ocular complaints are there. History of recent ophthalmic consultation in a private hospital somewhere in Bhavnagar. Patient had a fall off for 3 years. The patient was diagnosed with both eye vitritis with resolving PVD, gone under multiple Avastin injection in left eye. Left eye having secondary glaucoma, went under YAC PI 2 times, right eye underwent cataract surgery. The patient was still symptomatic after all treatment, so patient was referred to our hospital for further management. Patient was on prednisolone eye drop 6 times a day. History. History of using glasses since last 5 years. No history of head or ocular trauma. Family history not contributory. History of surgery. Right eye cataract was extracted in 2013. Left eye YAC PI done in 2014, followed by surgical PI 2 years after. Both eye underwent multiple Avastin injection from 2017 to 18. Other history not significant. Visual acuity in right eye 20/400 and left eye 20/80. IOP was normal. Fundus photos taken in both eye. On slit lamp examination, antechamber shows both eye is deep AC with cells 1+ and flare 1+. Iris, both eye few atrophic patches in left eye. At 12 o'clock position, PI is present. Pupil, right eye regular with reacting to light. Left eye fixed due to posterior synica formation. Right eye pseudophakic, left eye is complicated cataract. On fundus examination, a positive fundus examination, both eye having depigmented fundus with peripheral cry patches and sunset glow fundus. This is OCT picture showing macular edema and sunset glow fundus. With all that, we diagnosed patient as having VKH syndrome and started treatment with the immunosuppression drug azathioprine 50 mg BD for 1 month with tablet prednisolone with tapering doses over a period of 3 months and associated Schelkel tablet and ranitidine. With topical prednisolone eye drop 1% QDS. After subsequent follow-up of 2 months, patient visual acuity was improved to right eye 20/120, left eye 20/60. Patient has symptomatically improved. Discussion. Recent evidence indicate that virtually all patients with VKH can be successfully treated with immunomodulatory agent. Now there is trend to early immunosuppressive therapy in VKH. So treatment should be early and aggressive with high dose oral corticosteroid and immunosuppressant. Early aggressive treatment, young age and good vision within 1 month of treatment are associated with better visual prognosis. It is suggested to continue the treatment for 3 months with tapering over 6 months or a year. Good visual prognosis to prevent the recurrences. In our case, the patient had no other systemic associations apart from ocular finding, which led to delayed diagnosis and treatment. So it became important to follow thorough investigation and examination in case of uveitis and need to consider VKH as a differential diagnosis.
Okay, thank you, doctor.